So there's this feature called Instagram Guides on Instagram, and not many people are leveraging it or talking about it. In today's video, I'm telling you what they are, why you should be using them, and how you can actually start creating great content around them. Let's get into it. Hey, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited that you're here. I am Jessica Ludlow, and today we're talking about Instagram guides. You've heard about them, maybe, maybe not, but I'm here to tell you that you should be using them. First things first, here's the thing. Instagram provides new features, and the people who use all of the features will get rewarded. How? With more likes, impressions, and overall follows. It's true, it's proven, and it's known. So that's reason number one why you can be using it. But let's step away from the Instagram algorithm side and let's talk about the fact that it's a really convenient, great way for your audience to get lots of quick doses of information and value all in one gathered place. So if you don't know, Instagram guides are basically an ability for you to kind of clump your content together from your Instagram page into one specific little guide or booklet or almost like pamphlet that you can scroll through and get all the value in one little section regarding a certain topic. And it's all seen through your profile. It's just another button you can click. I'll put it up here on the screen so that you can help them get even more value quicker. In 2021 and beyond, people want fast, efficient. They want what they want and they want it now. So if you can provide people exactly what they need sooner rather than later, they're gonna like it and they're gonna want to come back for more. So that's why you should be using them. Let's talk about the how. So go into your guides and click create. Here you have the ability to group content that you have already created into one little booklet. Now, here's the thing. You want to make sure that there is some common theme between all of your content. So think, if you are a business coach, can you clump all of your strategies around selling online together? If you are a fitness coach, maybe you have a bunch of keto recipes that you want to use. Can you clump all of those posts into one little booklet for someone? Think about providing a little magazine of just what they want to see in one specific topic, whether it be super, super niche like keto recipes, or it's a little bit more broad like at-home workouts. So that is what you want to do first, is look at the content you already have created and then start clumping that together. The second part of this is to do market research. Go in to your Instagram polls, your Facebook, wherever your community is at, and find out what type of content they want to see more of. If there is a common theme of more manifestation practices, can you then create a bunch of content coming that will be posted to your feed and then clumped together for a guide? This is kind of pre-planning and planning out a guide in advance. Now, I know what you're wondering. Do I have to be posting it to my feed to get it into a guide? And the answer is yes. Because it's a collection of feed posts, it must be originally a feed post, if that makes sense. One other thing you want to consider is creating content that is going to want to be save worthy. So things like recipes, things like how-tos, things like tutorials, these types of things, or even education, these types of things are going to want and encourage people to save it and come back later so that they have it, so that they can go ahead and use it down the road. They might not use it right away when they originally see it, but down the road, definitely. Instagram guides is kind of like Instagram's way to create little Pinterest pins. It's a way to have a collection or a board, if you think about Pinterest, all on Instagram. Instagram's been working really hard to try to overtake every single feature that any other platform or app has. does, and really make it that one shop hub place for people to get everything that they need. Why? Because the longer you stay on Instagram, the more money that they make. They want you to stay on the platform as long as possible. So they've created yet another feature for you to do just that. Now, I know you're probably wondering, how often should you be making guides? Quality over quantity. Let me say that. If you have enough content to create a guide, okay, create it. However, don't just clump random stuff together and hope for it to do great. Also, create a call to action. Tell people about this new guide because it might involve a post that happened a year ago or 6 months ago that they can now get a refresh on and get value away from it. Make sense? So, one other thing that I want you to think about is, how many guides should you have total? The answer, again, lies in the fact that only as much and as often and as many as you have good quality pieces of content for. Like I said, we don't want to just clump random content together. That doesn't make sense. And at the end of the day, will not help our end user. So make sure you think as if you were your end user, if you think that this would be valuable, and then create the guide. Make sure you also put a captivating cover photo that's going to encourage people to click on it, as well as an enticing title for people to get a true inspiration and a true desire to click on it to read through all of them. I'm so excited that you loved today's video. Do yourself a favor and hit that thumbs up button and subscribe, and make sure you follow me on Instagram at I am Jessica Ludlow for more ways to grow your business through your favorite social media channels. I am signing off for now, and I will catch you on the flip side.